Hello there, guns and gals, and welcome to the network. I am Neptura, and today we're going to be looking at Navi's rotational skills, how they control final phases, and how that won them the European champion title. In the third match of day one, the zone shifts northeast to Yasnaya as Navi land north Jojopol. As the zone centers up, Navi move to the bank across from Rosshuck's bridge. They split up 3-1 north to cover the potential zones, but the circle goes west, favoring the one player. Navi explore the bank, letting other teams know they're there to keep full control of the north. Navi gatekeep 12-18 and get them off the north bank, while also keeping teams away from their position by taking third-party shots. The circle shifts south, so Navi cross the bridge and find Arkred underneath it. Tixie gets one knock and looks for the other player before getting knocked from across the river. A combined nade and UOL's third party clear Arkred. However, in the chaos, Navi don't realize it was a third party and therefore aren't prepared for UOL's rush. Smokes and nades elevate the pressure, and while they take three UOL players out, Rolkus comes out on top in the 1v2. This game shows Navi's strategy of keeping teams away from them during the last stages of the circle. They found the pivotal location to base their position on, having access to both the north and south wherever the zone decided to go. They furthered this by keeping one player on their ground, and moving the other three up to the compound north of the lake to clear that area for them if they needed it. Once the zone shifted south, they didn't hesitate to relocate just outside of zone. By doing this, they strengthened their position, avoiding a situation where a team could potentially gain ground in the zone by forcing Navi to retreat. By stepping outside of their territory, they ensured that a retreat would still keep the circle border intact and the enemy would still be at a disadvantage. They wait until 12-18, win their fight, and are low health to gatekeep the team effectively. By taking just enough shots to pressure teams already in fights, and to keep teams off their side, they effectively create space for themselves while keeping the teams together to fight it out amongst themselves. Although Arkred are under the bridge when Navi need to cross, they're aware they are there, and have the freedom to move the fight the way they want since they've kept other teams at bay even from the bridge. Their demise comes when UOL take a page out of Navi's own book and third party just as Navi win the fight. In this next match, Navi land Yaz Bridge and drive to their normal landing spot in North George as the first circle hits in a fairly standard zone. After looting, they go to the bridge complex just east of Jojopol to gatekeep any teams coming that way. As the zone moves south, they are proactive in moving to zone, entering from the northwest by the mountain. Chasing the zone, they next move to the large compound at the edge of the circle here before executing a third-party play to eliminate SMB and taking the house for their own. As the match progresses, Navi take a 2-1-1 split to effectively keep their house, loot their earlier compound, and gatekeep the north and west. Matic and Tixie are the two in the north, third-partying 12-18 and taking their position against S2G. Even though the opposing team gets past Navi, they continue the fight until eventually a third party from De Muerte leaves S2G as a solo player. The zone goes directly west, favoring Navi and forcing all the teams in the hills into the fields. One by one, teams are eliminated until De Muerte takes the trio they have left and push Navi, who are now regrouped in their house. Two Navi members are knocked as a result, however the enemy is eliminated and the team is still four strong. With Fubotalist out of the way, it leaves just Mad Bulls as a duo out in the field. Tixie and Matic go out in vehicles and make two flanks either side of the duo, which paired with the two players in the house, closes the net around MB. Kitsune joins in with a rush through the smokes, knocks one player while Meku on the roof gets the final kill for the win. Proactivity and third-partying are Navi's main key words. Every move they made in this match was the result of the constant gaining of information and the speed with which strategy was applied. Being the first to the bridge complex secured both a gatekeeping position and their entrance to a southern zone. The compound on the edge of the circle suited their needs, but they continued to look forward with two players going into zone as scouts. Timing their attack on the house across the fields just as the fight was ending and SMB were trying to recover meant far less effort and a chaotic advantage for Navi. With the win in the favor of Navi, this meant they had full control because they were not afraid of being split up. They were in a 1-1-2 breakup of the team, each doing his part to keep the other teams out of the circle. Kitsune was in the old compound covering the southern fields, Matic and Tixie gatekeeping the north, and Meku holding the newly acquired house. Another third party to 1218 meant they could now gatekeep S2G, while simultaneously forming a line like this to maximize the damage dealt as S2G drove past. This also enabled Navi to herd the team into the middle of the others to fight amongst themselves. As the dust starts to settle, there's only Mad Bulls left in the fields. Gathering around the duo was again a proactive move that shut down any plays MB could make, cornering them against the edge of the blue. Kitsune coming in with the vehicle pressured the duo to make a move, which would make them easier targets. For our next game, we're going to move forward to Day 4. In Sanhong, Navi land in Camp Alpha, expanding into the west and south regions of the island, before moving up to the east mountains. The zone shifts to the west, leaving Navi in a gatekeeping position on the high ground. Teams avoid the area, instead fighting it out in Camp Alpha. As the zone continues to shift in their favor, a couple of teams try to come into the circle, but it's all open below Navi and the teams are blocked effectively. The zone shifts south, leaving Navi out of the circle, however the damage has already been done and the Mad Bull solo dies in the blue just after the last member of De Muerte goes down at the hands of Navi. This is a great example of what happens when the circle favors Navi. They are really good at predicting zone paths, and they were confident that they wouldn't have to move away from that cliff, at least for a while. The way the circle shifted, and the landscape of that circle, ushered the teams from the north and south into Camp Alpha, which caused them to fight each other before turning their attention to Navi. The couple of teams who did try to come into Navi's territory were quickly shown the door, and had to find a way around the bottom of the cliffs. S2G made their way down from the north, while Arcred got ahead of the teams from Alpha, and De Muerte pushed past Exquisite Decode UK in the south. Navi did have to move eventually, but by that time there were only two players still up, and it was easy pickings given there was no real ground to fight from against Navi. In the last game of the tournament, Navi land again at Georgia Pole and the circle centers up, encompassing both the mainland and the Millie Island. As the next couple of phases move to the south mainland, Navi come up behind a fight on Potato Hill, but leave as the zone shifts away. They take up residence in a building on the northwest edge, one of only three compounds in the circle. UOL go for the push but are eliminated, while the remaining duo of Mad Bulls take the spot just under the ridge of the compound. Navi know that they're there and start chucking nades, knocking one but not getting the finish. Fights continue to the east and south, eliminating a lot of teams while Navi waits. The circle leaves the compound, so Navi throws smokes onto the ridge, but at the same time the full squad of World of Wonders cleans up Mad Bulls for them. Fernabache comes in from the south, throwing mollies onto Navi. World of Wonders gets a knock onto Tixie as the zone moves in, but is rezzed. Two players push World of Wonders, who have two down with Mekyu finishing the squad. Now with space to work with, Navi pushes forward out into the open against Arcred, who have one down. Fernabache are eliminated and only one is left for Arcred, who goes down as the smoke starts to lift. Navi take the win with 16 kills to secure their first place. Navi know exactly when to be quiet and when to strike. Having found a good position in the circle, Navi waited for the match to progress and the teams to take out each other. They only took fights if a team entered their zone, setting up a barrier around them that no team could nor wanted to cross. Once the zone finally shifted away from them, the last two teams were on the edges of the zone and the path was clear before them. Once this move happened, Navi were left as a confident full squad with lots of resources to take the final win. Navi have mastered the art of rotations, zone prediction, and third partying. They rarely take a new fight unless they need to. They aren't afraid to take out a team who has a prime position, but they don't take every fight they come across. They much prefer to surprise a team just coming off a fight and recovering. Navi's experience comes through on their circle knowledge and accurate predictions, always enabling them to have key positions in each phase. This skill also allows them to control the teams around them. They are always keeping teams away from them, pushing them into other areas already occupied and making the teams fight each other first. This sometimes can come back to bite them. Not every zone favors them and they end up having to push into an already crowded area. However, the amount of times their strategy works for them versus not allows them a few bad games and still come out on top. They are proactive with their rotations, using their knowledge of the circle and third-party plays to gain key positions early, using that position to herd enemies together, and then picking off with full confidence those remaining. Amongst other teams, I have not seen such a command of the final few phases as Navi has, and that is why they were winning from day one. Right, time for the YouTube spiel. If you want to see more of this type of content, y'all know what to do. A follow is free, a like goes a long way, and the bell rings when you tap it. I hope this analysis was food for thought, and I'd love to discuss this in the comments. If PUBG esport analysis is something you enjoy as much as I do, and you want a community to watch official tournaments in real time, I invite you to check out our live streams here on YouTube, where I stream events for live discussion. I also stream casual and ranking games with friends on Twitch every Tuesday, Friday, and Saturday. Link in the description! I hope you enjoyed this video, have a great day wherever you are, and see you next time.